这个2758决议啊，是在1971年，是10月25号的夜里11点多通过的，北京时间呢，就是26号的中午。其实那天呢，正好基辛格结束在北京的第二次访问，但是公开访问的，当时是叶帅为首去送他的。 那么我们正在那看着那个飞机，当然因为按照总理的规矩嘛，也不会上了飞机我们就扭头走，我们还站在那儿目送那个飞机起飞，消失在云端。就这个时候，有人从机场的什么地方跑过来，然后就说外交部刚才来电话，说是联合国通过了恢复我们的合法席位的决议。当时大家很高兴，有点突然，但是很高兴。我记得叶帅还回忆说。 刚才基辛格在车里头还说，你们进入联合国吧，要再等一年。所以对大家来说，这是又惊又喜吧。可能对大多数人来说，知道这是一个历史趋势，迟早这几年是要恢复的，但是没想到就在那一年。 At that time, we didn't have flights to go abroad, especially we couldn't go as far as New York. We couldn't cross the ocean. So we had to take a plane. We set off in a special plane from Beijing. We went through what is now Myanmar, Pakistan, Egypt, and Athens. At that time, we didn't have any relations, diplomatic relations with Greece, but we still were able to stop there. And were greeted there by officials from their foreign ministry. And then we arrived in France. But we were surprised to see, you know, our buses were moving along the street, not too fast because we were obeying traffic rules. But then we saw cars speeding by and then stopping and then speeding forward again and snapping pictures. Some of them rolled down their windows to take pictures of the buses. And there were even a few that stuck out their heads from the rooftops of the cars to snap away at the buses. And then when we stopped, I think outside the embassy probably, because we had to, the buses couldn't go in. So they could also, they got off there too and started taking pictures of us getting off the buses and getting our luggage and so on and so forth. Some of the people standing there. But the next day in the papers, we were so interested. They took all those pictures and they showed them in the next day's morning newspaper. And there was a picture that said, these are the Chinese ambassadors passing through Paris. And we looked at the pictures and they were our cooks because our cooks were very tall and stalwart. And they were very handsomely clad in brand new black woolen coats. They looked very good. They really did look like ambassadors, but those photographers didn't know who they really were. When we got on the plane from Paris to New York, we suddenly found the head of our delegation and some senior members were in the first class cabin. And they were just seated when Walter Cronkite from the American television network, CBS, came in with a television crew from nowhere and started interviewing him, asking, you know, how do you feel and what are you going to do and so on. We were not prepared for a long, long interview. So he cut it short after some time and went to his seat. And on that evening's show, we saw our delegation. But these are very new phenomena. That really showed that we were something that really interested people. We didn't realize that before. When the delegation arrived in New York for the first time to attend the conference, at the top of the elevator, not far from the top of the elevator, Mr. Bush was standing there, and he put out his hand to shake hands with the head of our delegation to welcome us to New York. And so although he did his utmost, and I believe he was faithfully carrying out his government's orders, he tried his utmost to block us to getting our rightful seat in the United Nations. But after the resolution was passed, he also said that, I don't remember the exact words, but that the reality is that this resolution shows the reality of the world. It shows what the people, or most countries, think. 就是那天的早晨，那个本来就是商务，一个专门的会，就是专门欢迎中国代表团。他是早晨10点半开始，就是马立克先发言，然后就一个一个国家，这个到中午稍微休息，接着又来，一直到晚上6点。就中间呢，还有好多人不断的就要求发言，但是排排排，后来排不上，到晚上6点呢都排不上了，后来就说把他们就纳入记录。 所以这个记录应该更，我记得当这么厚呢，1公分厚，是打印的那种，我记得英文的，而且那个非常热情洋溢，匈牙利代表是用中文讲普通话讲的，这个智利代表还引用了主席的诗词，这个很多，特别是像坦桑啊，像这个很多非洲国家，埃及啊什么，都是非常热情的表示欢迎，就是。 欢迎你们来，认为这个日子早就该来了。哎，你要看，我现在记不清楚那些内容，但是你要翻翻那里边，有很多可引的这个话，那从那儿就可以看出这些国家是什么心情，对中国恢复在联合国合法席位，他们是怎么想的，他们是怎么盼望的，他们期待我们怎么样？所以有一些国家独立了以后，他有困难，他要发展自己的经济，但是有困难。 我们虽然也是发展中国家，但是我们能帮多少忙，我们都尽量帮多少。比如说，修坦赞铁路，当时其实我们挺困难的，我们也，我们经济也很差，我们派去的很多，原来有些人都牺牲在那儿了，那个是个很艰苦的工作。当时就是西方是卡他们的脖子，特别是赞比亚，赞比亚有出铜。 但是过去它的铜的出，它要靠出口赚外汇嘛，它过去出口都是经过南非，但是南非它独立了以后，南非不高兴，就不给它运，那么当时它是出不了口啊，所以当时我们帮他们修建了这个坦桑铁路，它就可以从坦桑出口了，所以对他们是，咱们是真心帮助，而且是也是。 不是说是轻而易举的，我们也去了那么多人，不要说花钱，还搭了好多命呢。那到现在还有墓在那儿吗？他们很明白，我们是真心诚意的朋友，所以他们也支持我们，就是在联合国就投票会赞成恢复我们合法行为，而且很多其他的国家也觉得，就假装中华人民共和国不存那么大块头。 假装它不存在，就是台湾岛上那么小小的一个集团，就假装它能够代表中国，这个事儿也不合逻辑吧，也不符合社会现实嘛，不符合国际形势已经发展到的这个程度。那么现在我们中国呢，是一种真心诚意对待别人的国家，那么我们在国际活动当中也好。 包括在联合国里边，我们都是真心诚意的对待其他国家。我想在这种情况下，每一个国家都会做出自己的判断，怎么做对我最有利。那么他当然希望能够得到帮助，希望得到温暖吧，希望大家能够携手共进嘛，而不希望被人欺负、被人摆布。所以你看阿富汗，不就是这样吗？就是很多国家都是这样，伊拉克。 这都是这样，叙利亚，大家都是希望独立自主，我国家的事我说了算，不要你说了算，你也不知道我什么合适，对不对？我自己知道我需要什么，我自己知道，我知道我老百姓要吃饭，我知道我老百姓要有和平的日子，我不要在炸弹底下生活，所以我想，这是一个根本的真理，我觉得至今仍然有效。